Oh, hello there. My name is Cap and I do developer relations at sanity.io. And this is Bella. She does developer relations for Scooby Snacks. We live in Las Vegas, Nevada. And a fun fact about both of us actually is we both really love anime. So in this talk, we're going to cover conformance in Next.js. Come with me. All right, so like I said, this talk is on conformance, and conformance is new to Next.js, and it's a beautiful addition, if I do say so myself. Oh, and this is Hilo. Hilo loves treats, as you can see. So a quick history on conformance. Google had a small team of very experienced developers who did all the extensive code reviews, of course, and would flag anything that impacted app quality. So they thought, why not take the common things that were being found and make a system out of it? Thus, the conformance system was born. So this automated and enforceable system ensured a consistently high bar for app quality. That's pretty nice. So Google's web platform team experienced heavily with Next.js and began open sourcing their system. So Next.js knew it was time to get this automated system in Next.js. And that's what we are going to be talking about today. Here with me to explain this next part, the most important part, is what is conformance, is Polly. Now, I don't want to call conformance a new feature of Next.js because you can't really describe it as a feature. It's more a system that solves problems or points out problems in code. So there are rules that conformance follows to support the optimal UX experience. It catches things that might only be caught from an extensive code review or months down the road when a user complains about an image not loading. So some error or warning messages you could see in your Next.js app could be using an A tag to navigate to a page rather than link from next link, or using a link tag for an external style sheet rather than importing the styling files. Now, there's a lot of rules you can find that conformance would help catch in your code. So what I realize is that having conformance is like having a senior developer with me pair programming at all times. Super nice. And that takes me to the why. Why does this even matter to me? Can you imagine being able to have optimal code to create an optimal experience for your users without having to run it through another developer for a code review? Now, okay, conformance doesn't take away that need for the code review, but it surely wipes out a lot of the quick fixes to optimize your project. It takes the developer experience of creating a website or project and gives tips on how to improve your code. That ripple effects onto the users. Now the user experience is optimized and they get security, accessibility, and performance at a better rate. So added to Next.js 11, it was released on June 15th, 2021. That means you may not be affected by this yet. So to do a quick check, look into your package.json of your Next.js project to see what version of Next.js you are running. If you find out that you're outdated, that's okay. That's why we have the internet, so you can learn how to upgrade that awesome project of yours. And I'm gonna show you exactly how that's done. But first, let me tell you a quick story. So I got into tech about 3 years ago and was first exposed to React then. I was a React fan from the beginning, through and through. And then Next.js came along. It's kind of a sweet code love story, but I'm grateful it didn't have to become a love triangle between my first love, React, and my new love, Next.js, because Next.js is React. So as Next.js gets better and more optimized, I realize how good it really is for us developers. And conformance is one of those, like, you shouldn't have moments. I get a better developer experience by making sure my code is optimized for my users. It's too easy. So one of my projects was old Next.js. It felt new to me though. But then I upgraded and I ran that beautiful lint command. And let me tell you, there's a lot of errors, but I won't tell you, let me show you all that. All right, so to get our Next.js application upgraded, we are going to run the command npmi next latest, react latest, react dom latest. And this is going to upgrade us to Next.js 11. So now we are upgraded. We are next going to run the command npx next lint. How do we like to configure? We'll do strict because that is the recommended way. And all of this is going to be added in. Now we will need to run that command again in order to get all of our warnings and our errors to optimize our code. So now that that's done, let's run it again. Running that next lint command. And there are all of the warnings and errors that come from my application, my Next app. So let's go through a couple of these. So at the very top, there we go. Now we're at the top. So one of them, do not use image tag, use image from Next image. Great one. Custom fonts not added at the document level. This is discouraged, and it tells you where to go to find out more information. And it tells you which file this is in. Another one, external synchronous scripts are forbidden. And again, exactly where to find more information about that. This assign arrow functions to a variable before exporting. We're going to actually look at this one more in depth. We'll keep scrolling. This is a good error, the apostrophe. This can be escaped with the HTML character, and there's like a list of ones that you can choose from. Here's a good one, React hook. Use effect has a missing dependency. Great warning and great to know. Let's keep scrolling. And we have a lot of these. Image elements must have an alt prop. Don't forget those alt props, and we'll show an example of that. And my giant list of missing keys. We'll definitely want to fix those. That's probably all 47. Just kidding. I don't know. So yeah, that is my list of errors and warnings. So the first one, let's look at assign arrow functions to a variable. So it shows us where to find it, that it's a warning, so it's going to be yellow, and what the error is. So we're going to go to the file, and we see underlined in yellow the error and what the warning was. So we're going to fix that by naming it. And best practices is naming our functions. By naming our functions, we are able to debug better, and our code is optimized and organized. So we've named it with the function headline. That one's done. Next one, the apostrophe can be escaped with the HTML character, and it gives you a couple options to choose from. So we go into our code. It is an error, so it's underlined red. It shows the error. And then quick fix, view problem, that kind of stuff, we've added in the HTML character, and now that error is gone. So that's really awesome because we want to have that HTML character in there instead of the apostrophe. Next one is the giant list of missing keys. So we're going to want to fix all of those because it's good to have the key. And if you look to the right, you see all the red for just this file where there are missing keys. I'm not going to show you me fixing each one of these, but as we add a key to each one of these, that red line will go away. Next, we have do not use image tag, use image from Next image. And we also have image elements must have an alt prop. So let's go fix that warning for both of those for this one. So we have both of the warnings pop up when we hover, and we have that yellow squiggly line behind it. So we know that we are in the file that has the warning associated with it. So to fix it, we import Next image. We use that image, and we also added in the alt prop. So by doing that, we have optimized our image handling in Next. And for accessibility, we have the alt tag. So we're good to go. So there you have it. Next.js comes with a handful of awesome new features or systems, conformance being just one of them. So go ahead, hit that upgrade command today, and let me know about your developer experience with Next.js 11. Thank you for coming to my talk. My animals also thank you. You can find me on Twitter at @kapehe_ok, where I tweet all things tech, working out, and miscellaneous stuff. You never know, I never know. Mahalo for hanging out, and we'll see you around.